of
the y equals the f inverse. Replace the value of the derivative of the function f of 1, which is 5 over 2, to get 1 over 5 over 2, or the reciprocal of 5 over 2 to get 2 over 5. And this is the slope of the curve y equals the inverse function f at the point 3 comma 1. This example, given the function f of x equals x over x minus 8, find the inverse function f inverse and the slope of the line tangent to the graph of the f inverse at the point 2 comma 16. Let's check the 2 comma 16, this other pair for the inverse function, or it means the f inverse of 2 equals 16, which is 2 equals the function f at 16. Let's check for f of x equals x over x minus 8. If the x is 16, so 16 divided by 16 minus 8, which is 2, check so we get the right order pair. So for the function f of x, we use the order pair 16 comma 2. Number two, we're gonna find the slope of f inverse of the tangent line to this f inverse. Which is m of the tangent line, or the derivative with respect to x of the inverse function. Third one, we're gonna find the inverse function. Treat f of x as a y, and then interchange x to y to x, dx equals y divided by y minus 8, and we're gonna solve for y. Multiply both sides by y minus 8 to have x multiplied by y minus 8 equals y. Distribute x to both terms to get x times y minus 8 times x equals y. Solve for y by collecting the like terms. Subtract y both sides, add 8x both sides, and then factor the y out to get y multiplied by x minus 1 equals 8 of x. Therefore, y equals 8x over x minus 1, which is the inverse function of 8x divided by x minus 1. And next, we're going to find the derivative of the inverse function. Part two, to find the derivative of 8x over x minus 1, this is the quotient form. So we're going to use the quotient rule. Treating u as 8 of x, the v as x minus 1. The u prime is 8, the v prime is 1. With the quotient rule, v u prime minus u v prime over v squared. The v is the quantity x minus 1, multiplied by u prime, which is 8, minus u, which is 8x. Multiplied by the v prime, which is 1, divided by the v squared, the v, which is the quantity x minus 1 squared. And we evaluate at x equals, it equals 2 for the inverse function form to get 2 minus 1 multiplied by 8 minus 8 times 2 divided by 2 minus 1 squared to get 1. So we have 16 minus 8 minus 16. So the answer is negative 8. another way that we can do by using the formula, as f of x is x over x minus 8, to find the derivative of the inverse function, it's the same as the reciprocal of the derivative of the original function. So to find the derivative of x over x minus 8, using the quotient rule, u is x, or the numerator is x, and the v is x minus 8, the u prime is 1, the v prime is also 1. The formula is the v u prime minus u v prime over v squared to get the v, which is the quantity x minus 8 multiplied by u prime or 1 minus u, which is x multiplied by v prime, which is 1 divided by the v squared or the quantity x minus 8 squared. And then simplify it to be x minus 8 minus x divided by x minus 8 power 2. X and x reduced to have negative 8 divided by the quantity x minus 8 power 2. Evaluate at x equals, in this case, we're going to evaluate at x equals 16, which is the input of the original function, or the pair is 16 comma 2. So equals 16 to get negative 8 divided by 16 minus 8 quantity squared, which is negative 8 divided by 8 squared, or negative 1 over 8. And then bring it back to the formula, which is 1 over the reciprocal of negative 1 over 8 to get negative 8 as a result, which is the same as the result obtaining from finding the derivative of the inverse function, which is more work to do.